Hi, my name is John Nolson, and welcome to the second video on keyframing in spine. In the previous video, we already covered some of the properties you are able to keyframe, and in this video, we'll be covering the rest. So let's get started. In spine, we have something called events, and these events can be triggered during an animation. For example, on Spine Boy, we trigger a footstep event, which can be seen when I click the playback button here to see the animation. You can see we have footstep. To key these events, we open up the events node, like so. You can see we have a footstep event. And all these events have a key next to them. Now, if I click here, we also have some values we can set. For example, if I change this value here, you can see the key has now turned orange. And if I click it now, we will now have set a key for this event. If I scroll all the way down to the bottom of the dope sheet here, we can see events. We have event footstep. We have a key set here, and the key I just created here. I've opened up a different version of Spine Boy that utilizes meshes. And meshes can also be keyed. And to set a key for a vertex position of a mesh, we click on the key button next to the mesh in the tree. Let me just do that. So I select the mesh here, the torso, and next to the torso mesh here in the tree, we have a key. I could go here to a different frame and I could drag one of these vertices here, like so. And now I can set a key for this. Now when I scrub the timeline, that vertex will be moving. Keep in mind that when you set a key for a mesh, all the vertices will be keyed, and not only the ones that have changed. But we'll cover meshes in depth in a later video. Constraints for inverse kinematics can be found under the constraints node. Now I'll expand that here. We already have four constraints in this project. If I select one of these, it will allow me to change the bend direction from positive or negative, or I can change the mix value. Keying these values is done by pressing the key button here next to each constraint. How inverse kinematics will work will be covered in depth in a future video. If I select a bone and then go down here on the right and see the properties for the bone, you can see we have a flip property. Now this flip property can be keyed, and we can key both the X and Y value. For example, currently have the hip selected, and if I click here to flip it on X, I can now key this, and we have a flip key set on the first frame. I can go to a different frame, change it, and key it again, and now when I run the animation, I'll be flipping my animation back and forth. Please note that it is possible that these flip buttons will be removed in a future version of Spine, should we implement classical scaling, as I mentioned in the first tools video. The K button on the keyboard is the default hotkey for key edited, which sets a key for all changes not yet keyed. And let me show you what this means. Now, first I'll go to a different frame here. I'll rotate the torso bone and now I'll hit K. So now we keyed everything that was edited. We see now the key here is red, and I could have done this for multiple bones. For example, do like so. Now, if you notice here in the tree, we have multiple keys that hasn't got their values keyed yet, but if I hit K now, they will all be keyed, and we have now stored the pose that I just made. When auto key, which can be found in the dope sheet, is enabled, a key will be set automatically anytime a change is made, and we'll cover auto keying once we start looking into the dope sheet in detail. Should you happen to pose your skeleton in the wrong timeline position and you didn't key it yet, the pose will be lost, as mentioned earlier, when the timeline position is changed. To recover the pose at the new timeline position, you can press Command C. Should you have a change to redo when the timeline position changed, the pose can then not be recovered. And let me show you how this works. So I'll open up Spineboy again, go to animate mode, make sure you have auto key off. I'll go to a different frame again. Then I'll rotate this leg here. Then I go to a different position on the timeline. You see it pop back. But now if I hit Command C, it actually restored the pose. And now I can set a key for it. There are some differences between running animations in Spine and running them at runtime. If no key is set at all for a value, the animation won't change. The skeleton is always reset to the setup pose before an animation is applied in Spine. Let me try and illustrate what this means. If I go here and I create a new animation, we'll call this temp, like so, and I'll set a key for the body bone here and rotate it. And while we have a small animation here, if I set this to playback and I switch between the run animation and the temp animation, despite me only having set a key on the body bone here, all of the bones snap back to the setup pose. So at runtime though, the programmer can decide if the skeleton should be reset to the setup pose before applying an animation. And if he doesn't apply the setup pose, that means that if no key is set, then the skeleton will keep whatever value was set last. An example where this can be beneficial is if I go to setup mode here and I find the weapon here. We have a weapon slot. On this, we have an attachment which is currently set to be hidden. Go back into animate mode. I can change this. Let me find the run animation again here. So let's say that I set this to be visible and I set a key for it. Now, if I run this animation like so, and at this point, I switch to a different animation, for example, a temp, which doesn't have any key set for the weapon. At runtime, if I don't set it back to the setup pose, the weapon attachment would still be visible. So that means I don't have to set a key for every single animation just to show the weapon. Now, this can also be undesirable. Now, let's say I create a new animation here and I'll call this root rotation. Then I'll set a key here in the rotation for the torso. I'll just rotate the root bone. I'll just rotate this at 45 degrees. And I'll just set another one here so I can actually play back. So we changed the rotation here in the root bone. And then at runtime, if I'm not resetting it back to the setup pose before switching animation, it would actually have this animation also rotate at 45 degrees because currently the root bone does not have any key set in the run animation. A solution to this is to key every value at frame 0 for every animation. We do this by, I'll activate the temp animation, selecting all the bones, and then at the first frame here, I'll just set keys for everything. But this can be tedious for the animator, and it's also pretty inefficient, since at runtime, every value is set every time the animation is applied, which is often 60 times per second. And each value that is keyed has a small cost, which is usually not something you should worry about, but when all values are keyed, the cost adds up, and it may be an issue if there are many skeletons being animated on screen at the same time. So the most efficient approach is to have the programmer reset the skeleton's bones to the setup pose before applying an animation. For attachments, the programmer could choose to reset some or all of the slots to the setup pose when an animation changes. Okay, so with that out of the way, Now's a great time to explore how keying works in Spine. And if you haven't already set up your own skeleton, you can use one of the example projects that came with Spine and create a new animation by clicking the animation node here and then clicking new animation. Then what you do is you just pose your skeleton and then you set a key and go to a different frame and you pose your skeleton again and you set the keys. And you can do this by either pressing K to set the keys, or you can have auto key on. Okay, so in the next video, we will go more in depth with animating and explain some of the different approaches that can be used to animate your skeletons. And I hope to see you there. I also hope that this video has been helpful. So, bye for now.